So nice of you all to join. Thank you so much. Hi. How are you?
I'm good. So nice to see you.
Same here. It's such a pleasure to have you on this live chat. Hi,
Yeah.
Sabina. Hi, Yusuf. Thank you for all your comments.
That's my little Yana wants to say hi
Yana.
to everybody.
Hi.
Mama,
Hi. Thank you so much. Thank you so much.
Yes.
Hi, Shubhangi. And you're looking very, very pretty. Love your earrings. Is this from
Absolutely.
the famous P Square jewelry?
I stopped wearing anything else apart from pink jewelry.
Oh
Be it
yes.
wedding,
Hi,
be
Niti.
it party. Yes. Hi, Minty.
Amazing. I'm good, Yusuf. I'm very good. Thank you. Hi, Rinku. So nice to see all of you here. So very, very quickly, I'd like to welcome you all to this nice engaging chat show that we have. It is called hashtag Wine Pe Charcha with Manjula. So cheers to that.
Yes, I let me see my glass.
Yes.
Oh,
Cheers,
here I
cheers,
got
cheers.
mine too.
Yes.
Cheers to
So,
everybody who has joined
cheers to
us
everyone.
for this chat.
So, very quickly, I'll introduce myself for those who know me. I'm Manjula. For those who don't, I'm Manjula. Okay, and I am a wine and spirits expert. Done my MSc WSET from London. Okay, and of course, I'm a life coach as well. And this particular session, just about a couple of 30 minutes or so, is dedicated for Wine Pe Charcha series, where I discuss little basics on wine. And of course, I have the beautiful guests who join me, and we will talk about what the guests have to share and what they are looking forward to in this coming year with their businesses. So this is something what we will be discussing. So I will want to hand over, the next few minutes to my beautiful guest, Priya Sharma, the director and designer of very, very intricate hand-embroidered jewelry, very famous in India and, of course, out of India. She has only exported. So I will leave the rest to Priya to introduce herself. Yes, Priya.
Thank you, Manju. It's an honor to be part of this live session. And let me just do cheers first to you.
Cheers.
Many more sessions,
Thank
okay? Talking about myself, as you know, my name is Priya Sharma, and I have this business, hand embroidered jewelry. As you can see, these are all made, handmade, hand embroidered, and given a finish with the fabric. So they are very, very light. So basically, I started this almost as a passion almost 4 years back. And I set up an export company. I do a lot of exhibitions abroad. And so my product, I have a lot of customers abroad who appreciate this intricate work. And but because of this pandemic, everything is on hold. And I'm waiting to go back to my workshop and create a lot of interesting stuff. I'm thinking of launching in India. Of course, there's not much of Indian market I have as of now because I've been concentrating only on international market, and I'm very confident now in international arena. So I would like to concentrate on Indian market as well. So let's see how it goes. Yeah,
Absolutely,
Manju?
absolutely. Thank you so much for sharing that, Priya. Also, I would like to tell all our viewers that we are not only friends, but we are great friends. Share same
Yes,
birthday as well.
it's a
Yeah.
secret. We share birthday, 13 December rocks. Yeah.
Yes, 13 December. So, to begin with, yes, this is Wine Pe Charcha. So, I would like to ask my guest, Priya, what is your favorite wine and how did you start off with wine? What is your wine story?
My wine story, yes, I was working with Jet Airways, so my introduction to wine is basically because of the airline. And once you are introduced to wine, I'm sure there's no look back, right, Manju? So you really want to have the best of wines. You want to explore what is there in the international market, and of course India as well. I normally prefer red wine. But during for in case it's depending upon what I'm eating, if it's a fish or something light meal, then I prefer white wine. But most I'm a red wine person. Off lately, thanks to you, because of whatever you have given us, you know, your knowledge, we started liking a lot of Indian wine as well. And right now I'm having this Sula.
Yes.
Red, which is very nice. I like it because it's not very dry. And it's, I think, combination of a dry and normal. You know, it's not very sweet
it's not
as well.
Very dry. Yes.
Yeah, so it is very soothing for my palate.
Yeah. So that's amazing. Priya, with few glasses, few sessions, and now you are already like an expert. You know that.
Oh amazing. Yes.
So
thanks to you.
Powerful. Yes, you know, having said that, of course, thank you for sharing those insights. So here, of course, journey is journey. We begin somewhere. We must have started. So Jet Airways definitely is for most of us. You know, we must have seen our wine for the first time, or tried, you know, for the first time. And of course, it has never stopped and it's continuing. Yeah. So today, Priya, we are going to be also discussing some basics about wine. A lot of them still, when we say, okay, what are the different wines, we just say, oh yeah, there is red wine, there is white wine. So I would like to just give a little brief about what different wines we have, okay, in the market today. So of course, there is red and white. So it falls in a big category which is called as still wines. So these are called still wines. So red and white wines, which are of course in the market, are called still wines. Then we have sparkling wines, which definitely like the champagne, the one that we have, champagne, or also the sparkling wines that we find other places as well, from Italy and Spain. They all have different sparkling wines. So that is one. And of course then you have fortified wines. So fortified wines are your port wine, your sherries, Madeiras. So this is your fortified wines. And the last but not the least category is your aromatized wines, you know. So we all are aware of the red and white wines. So we know that they are made by, you know, grapes. But wine can be made not only from grapes, but also you could make wine from fruits.
Fruits, yes.
Yeah, so
a lot of people make it at home,
yes.
You know, adding lot of spirits in it, and very potent.
Yes, if the lockdown doesn't, you know, kind of, now of course it is unlocking phase by phase, but if it takes a lot of time, I think I'm going to start making my own wine at home.
So, you can share the recipe.
Absolutely, absolutely. You'll find that on my YouTube video. So yes, so these are something. So sparkling, we all must have definitely seen, where you have the fizz, which is there, the CO2, okay, which is trapped in the bottle itself, so to create the fizz, you know, for all your celebrations and all that. So your whenever the wine is getting, you know, the grapes are getting fermented, so it is the yeast is you know, kind of giving out, converting the sugar into alcohol and carbon dioxide. So with still wines, you let the carbon dioxide escape. But with sparkling wine, you try and trap them, and of course, that is what you have. You know, it's a natural bubbles that you have in the bottle. That is why they are so expensive as well, you know. And with fortified wines, what they do is they, earlier, you know, there's a little history to it, very interesting. That, you know, many, many, obviously it is 4,000 years old, you know, wine, so it has great history. So they didn't want the wine to get spoiled. So what they started doing is adding liquor to it, some kind of spirit to it. So it stays for, you know, fresh for
longer,
a long time without getting spoiled. So that is how they started off with the fortified wine. So what they add, if you ask me, would be brandy. So they add brandy to the wine. So that's how it becomes more and more, you know, potent. So you will see generally people say that after drinking port wine, yeah, mujhe chadh gayi.
Yeah. So tell me one thing, Manju, I have a question.
Yes.
This fortified wine are mostly the port wines, you're saying, the dessert wine, right?
Yes. Usually they you can have them, you know, they are called digestives. So generally you will have them after your food, yes.
Okay.
So that is why they are supposed to be had in, you know, small quantities, not like the regular wines,
not,
you know. Yes.
Yes.
Hi, Jigna. So nice to have all these. I mean, we're just taking a little time to say hello to also all of them who joined. So
yes. Hi, Jigna.
Yes.
I also know a few of them.
Yes. Yes. Hi, Kavyami. So nice to have you. Yes. So
I think Manju, your camera.
Pardon me. I'm sorry. Sorry to say, sorry that's my kid's shelf. Yes. This is about your fortified wine. So you could have the sweet one, which is your port wine, or you could have sherry as well, which is dry, you know. So depends on when you add the brandy. So if you add it during fermentation, so, you know, it will kill there, because a lot of alcohol actually kills the yeast. That is why the flavor left in the wine. Okay, so that is your port wine, which is red and sweet, and we enjoy it. You know, it's potent. Sherry's, there is Madeira's, Marcella's, there are all these, you know, port wines, fortified wines, which are also used in your cooking, you know, to kind of give it a little twist. Mm-hmm. So this is about your fortified wines. And as I told you, they do have a lot of, you know, alcohol in them. So you have to drink responsibly. So of course, just to highlight, this session is not about making people alcoholic. It is all about letting them know that we have to drink responsibly and savor. Unlike, you know, just drinking wine and getting drunk, that doesn't happen with wine. You have to drink, enjoy, savor. And finally, is something called as aromatized wine. So aromatized wine, you must have heard, also for our viewers, it is called as vermouths. I don't know if you've heard them, but vermouths are usually used.
Yes.
You know, they are your aromatized wine. You will find them in a lot of cocktails. Especially
martinis.
Martinis.
Yeah. Martinis.
So the brand is, you know, of the one of the very famous brand for vermouth is Martini and Rossi. And you will find them everywhere. So, of course, it is also a wine. So what they used to do earlier, many, many years ago, is what I'm talking about, the history, that there was this one gentleman who wanted even the ladies to kind of have great, you know, they should enjoy all these wines. We're talking about many years ago, many thousands of years ago. So he kind of, you know, added a lot of aromatics into the wine, like herbs, flowers, spices, and you know, whatnot. And they used to actually use it for even medicinal purposes, you know, many hundred years ago, or, you know, you could take it back to even 1,000 years ago. So that's how it started. And they felt that, you know, this, so basically a little vermouth, and you could add just a dash of soda or something like that and just enjoy it, you know. He felt the ladies would rather enjoy it like that. But of course, times have changed. So you find vermouths a lot in cocktails these days. The famous one is our very own Bond's
yes.
cocktail. You know, he says shaken but not stirred.
Not stirred, yeah.
Yeah. So that is one thing. Maybe towards the end, I would definitely give them a little quick recipe of this cocktail as well if they stay. Yeah. So that is something that I wanted to share about various basics about wine. Wine itself is like a huge, huge, you know, topic with great history, and we cannot really, you know, the more you get into it, the more deeper it takes.
The more there is,
spend a little more time with it. So for those, of course, you, all of you, you could keep a track. Do follow my Insta page, and I will be sharing my YouTube link as well, so you could see for the upcoming sessions on wine in detail. But now that we have our guest here, I would like to ask her about how is it going? What are you doing these days, you know, to keep yourself upbeat?
Very, very busy. Yeah, this lockdown is. So my routine is pretty busy. I get up early, as you know. I do a lot of exercise. So getting up in the morning is my routine. I'm a morning person. Get up at 6 o'clock. By 6:30, I'm ready to do my yoga. I start with my breathing exercise, followed by Ashtang Vinyasa, which is for around 45 to minutes to 1 hour.
Okay.
And yes, and after that, I have my cup of tea, and then I'm charged up. By 8:30, I'm ready to do all the household chores. So that gives me a lot of energy in the morning. And then, of course, my little baby keeps me busy. Cooking, cleaning, washing, you know, it's never ending.
I think you're a superwoman, you know.
Yeah. By evening, again, evening is a time where my husband and I, and my daughter, we like to do again exercise. Sometimes we do a little bit of weight training. So 5 days in a week we do. And it's become now part of our routine, you know, in lockdown to do all this. And that's about it.
That's amazing. It's a full day.
Yep, very, very much.
Yeah. How are you looking at the future of P Square Jewelry now? The hand.
Yes, it is an area of concern for us because we are purely into export. And, you know, I used to love traveling, going to places, Paris, and just came back from Milan in February, you know, after, you know, doing my exhibition. So now things would be different. My upcoming show is in September in Paris, Bijorka, but we've already made the payment, everything is done. But I think by then, the way it is going in India and especially in Mumbai, I don't know how it would be, the travel guidelines, would we be able to travel or not. So any which ways, we are planning to start in 2020, Indian market, you know, more on social media platform. So I'm going to concentrate on that. Maybe on Instagram, maybe website, and have, you know, more... My products to be seen in Indian market, and let's see. So I'm going to take it as it comes, and hopefully it should be all right.
Absolutely.
I'm just waiting to go back to my workshop. There are a lot of things which are pending, and I have a lot of ideas, but let's see how it goes. Just being hopeful.
Absolutely. We wish you all the very best for that. You know, and we hope that you know, all this you know, COVID issues and situation improve in our country, and you know, we do find our space to work, and you know, definitely we all want to get back to work and you know, doing the best of our ability, isn't it? So also want to check with you about your jewelry. It used to be mostly exported, isn't it? So are you looking at doing something specifically only for India, designs per se?
So I do a lot of earrings, and brooches are you know, very famous, you know, in international market, and I supply to a lot of museums like London Museum, Victoria Albert Museum, then MoMA in US. So they're very famous, and seeing that trend, we see that in India also it's coming back. You know, the wearing brooches of different bugs and beetles and the different animals. So I'm not going to change entirely for Indian market different, because I see that Indian customers and the consumer, they are very experimental. And my product is something very, it's niche. And it's something, you know, statement jewelry. So I don't want to entirely change and try to make something Indian, because it's very international, which I can wear it with Indian wear, or I can wear it with my dress and be ready, and it's very light. So I want to be on the same line and see what I have already a lot of products. So just see that how my customers in India, they're going to accept it, not accept it, and how they're going to like it. So I'm going to see, let's see how it goes. So I have a lot of plans, and hopefully it should work.
It should work, yes.
We all, yes, I'm going to do a lot of promotions on my Instagram, handle. For all the viewers who don't know me, my Instagram handle is p_jewelry, and you can follow me. And I'll be putting a lot of stuff in it, and then I do a lot of sales also in that Instagram handle, and that's about it. That's what my plan is.
Great. We have to work out our plan, and plan to work it out, right? So
there's one question, Manju. I think there's one question from Shivani. What inspired you, Priya, to start?
Yes, I was about to leave. Almost we are coming to the end, so just wanted to end the session for questions. If there are any questions for Priya and for me, please post it now. And very quickly, I'd like to just say hello to everyone who had just joined. So Jigna, Parvez, thank you, Fawad, for joining. Thank you so much. Thanks a lot.
Yeah, there are many people. Tina, Nikita.
Yes. So, if there are any questions, if you'd like to ask me, and of course, Priya, please do put it right now. So, yes.
Yeah, So she just asked, I'll just take a minute to answer that. What inspired me? So I basically, because of my travel, I always had this thing of creating something, and very artistic by nature. So I wanted to take something Indian, but take it to the international level.
Yes.
So I thought embroidery is something in India. Everybody does it, in your saris, in your dress material. But it was something different where if you put it on your, jewelry and showcase to the world. So that's what my plan was, and it worked.
Absolutely. They say Tina is your loyal customer, like us also.
Oh, yes. She is my loyal
customer. Even I own a couple of your pieces. And for my, I want to pick up something for my dress today so I could wear that next time. So nice that you're here with us. Thank you. Thank you so much. Thank you, Minty. Hi, Payal.
Hi, Payal.
Hi, Jiggy. Jigna, yes. Thank you. Do let us know if there are any other questions, anything at all. So there was this one question from Shefali, who was asking, "What am I drinking?"
That was very important question.
Hi, Samundrika. So nice to have you here. So
hi, Samundrika.
Yes, it's a beautiful feeling to see all our friends.
Yes,
made an effort to join.
Yeah. Hi, Gauri Divi. Nice to see you.
Yes. So I was drinking a Chardonnay. So that's one of my favorite, I would say that since we're talking about wines, that's one of the best ways to describe. So those who are beginners, we just say, yes, I'm drinking a red wine, or I don't know what I'm drinking, So those who become a little better with it, then they start saying that. And those who become too perfect, they say that, oh, I can't do without my Chardonnay, or I only drink Pinot Noir, But as and when you grow, I think the best wine would be the wine that you enjoy with your friends, isn't it?
Absolutely.
Samundrika, she's asking, what is the reason? Oh, thank you.
Oh, glowing skin.
I think right now in India, with all the COVID and no one to help, I think you're just working at home.
So Manju, there's a question by Abhina. Is it okay to have red wine during the day, as one perceives it is an evening drink generally?
I would definitely say yes, because depending on what wine that is, if it is very, very, if heavy wine for that matter, like let's say if you're like a cab saw, it's with heavy tannins and all that. So maybe you would want to put keep that for the, chill it for the evening. The ones like lighter wines, maybe like a Pinot Noir, I would say, even there are some rosés maybe that you could probably have it during the day. So a light red wine is definitely a go, at least from my side. I will never say no to wine. Yeah. Hi, Neetu. So nice to see. Disha, hi. Hi. Thank you so much for joining us, everybody. And as promised, I have a cocktail recipe of the bonds. Very, very simple. Shaken, not stirred, right? So if you have the vermouth with you, so vermouths could come with, you know, very sweet, or you could get something which is not so sweet. So anything in the wine world which is not sweet is called dry. We will not say, oh, it is bitter. So we will say it is dry. So yes, you could have a dry vermouth with you if you have it. Get it at any, you know, wine shops. They do, you know, stock them. So you could add 60 ml of vodka, your favorite vodka. You could add that along with about 25 to 28 ml of your dry vermouth. Okay, and of course, dash of bitters. So bitters are again like essence that we find, like vanilla essence. So something like that you have. A neutral spirit added with lot of aromas and, you know, like peels of lemon and things like that to make it more flavorful. So that is why even if just two drops you put, it gives you the...
It's enough.
So you add two dashes of bitters and you garnish it with the olives or a lemon twist. So, you know, peel basically.
Then you're ready.
Then you're ready to be...
Then you're ready to rock and roll.
Like the bond... Or bond women like us. Yeah. Yes. So thank you, Ansh is here. My kids have joined me. Yes, definitely, definitely. I will write this down, the recipe in the section as well. Thank you so much. Also, I'd like to let everybody know I completed a very short course on bartending as well for the last 8 days.
Wow.
So what I was doing at home. So yes, it is interesting. So Juhi is very, very appreciative of your jewelry collection.
Oh, thank you, Juhi.
So classy, yes.
Oh, there's a suggestion for men. Yes. Yes, Abhina. I have few brooches for men. I'm going to share it with you soon. Thank you.
And Samundrika has asked a question on, you know, any plans of introducing your product in Asian market as well?
Now it will be online, so wherever you want, we can just deliver it, and you just need to take care of courier charges.
That's amazing, you know, that's so beautiful. Yeah. So, P-Square Sisters has have asked two questions. Please WhatsApp us the recipe. Of course, I will. And thank you, Priya. Thank you, Payal. Congratulations. Thank you so much. And what is the other question I'm looking for?
Thank you. Yes, Payal, I will share it. Thank you.
Thank you, Ansh. Thank you. Thank you so much, Disha. Thanks a lot. Thank you so much for all of, you know, you joining for us. And Tina, thank you. It is my pleasure to introduce whatever we can do, because wine world could be so overwhelming for most of us. Yeah. It's too much of information, and then that is one of the reasons why a lot of us don't, you know, it is, wine is not approachable for a lot of us. So like how we probably will take to vodka, we don't so easily take to wine because we are wondering, should I not?
So therefore, how to
necessary, it is necessary, according to me, you know, in my opinion, Priya, that we should be attending some of wine tasting sessions so that you could pick up a wine that might interest you, and not only one wine, then you might want to know what other wine, because you just can't drink one wine for all your life, isn't it?
Yes. And I must tell you all that I had attended a lot of wine sessions, you know, with Manjula. And I think my knowledge about wine has really increased, you know, to another level. Now I'm very confident. Of course, I've been drinking wine for a while. But then how to drink, both all are available in the market. And especially the Indian wines, which you have introduced, it was amazing. Maybe in our next session, you can always talk about the good Indian wines, you know, which we can recommend, and the sparkling ones also, because those were amazing. Now, whatever, whenever we have something, we just call up Manju and ask, please give us the list. What should we order?
Thank you so much.
Yeah, it's great.
Thank you so much, Priya. Thank you so much. There are a few questions for you here, Priya, about your work plan after lockdown. If you're delivering your products now, so you could just answer a few questions for our viewers today.
Yeah, as I said, since after lockdown, I would be concentrating on online platform, the social media, and I'll be putting up a lot of products. And in case you want to order, then in Indian market, I'm talking about. So even one or two pieces also would be available. Like if you order one piece, we can just courier it to you at your place, because that was not possible before, because we were not showcasing anything in Indian market. Until unless you were my friend, I would just give it to you.
We're so fortunate.
Yeah, but yes, that is what my plan is. And okay, now next, what's your Priya? Are you delivering your products now as well? Yes, Shefali, whatever there is on Instagram, you can just have a look on @peacekar_jewelry. In case you like something, you just let us know, DM us, and I'll let you know the price. And within a week's time, we'll send it across. And I know you are my loyal customer as well. Yes.
There are, how much time does it take to make one piece? It's the question from for one pair of
Yeah, it is quite tiring in the sense, see, when if I talk about the initial piece, my first sample. So first I need to visualize what I am looking for, you know, what exactly I want. And then I need to draw it. Once I draw it, then I need to sit with all the raw materials and try to adjust. Once it is there in my mind, then I sit with my craftsman and then start doing it. Now, sometimes what happens, what you have thought, it doesn't come out nicely. So then there will be a lot of trial and error. So it takes normally a week to get the final one sample. Once it is ready, I have one sample. Then if somebody gives me order, then it takes 3 to 4 days, provided I have raw material. So initial work to make an initial sample, it is quite a task.
Amazing, amazing.
But then that's
a lot of work. Absolutely. Thank you. So there's a question here about the Indian wines which have won awards. Definitely there are a lot of them. I am going to be posting them in the chat in this IGTV video as well for your information, also on my stories. So definitely you will be able to see that. Again, just a very quick hello to Simi. Vinay, so nice to see you. Thank you so much for joining. Hi, so lovely. Women Who Whiskey. Oh, I love you for joining today. So Neeti and Shivani, yes, thank you for joining all of us. I think we've exceeded our time because we've got a lot of questions and we have so many viewers today. So is there anything else, any other question at all? Otherwise, I think you will find us, find this video, find our chat, to go back to in my YouTube channel as well, as both of our IGTV as well. So you will have a look at that. So I hope you will enjoy the different type of wines that we discussed, still sparkling. And if anybody asks you what other wines we have, you could very confidently say, yes, we do have fortified and we have aromatized wines as well. Yeah, so that's an interesting
thing,
isn't it? So enjoy the cocktail if you've got the recipe noted down. If
yes.
You be putting that down in the video as well. Yeah. Thank you so much, Priya.
Thank you. My pleasure.
On the Wine Pe Charcha. I hope you you enjoyed. And
yes.
It was amazing to know your work and how you're planning to take it forward, because we are all worried. Because will we get our P-Square jewelry pieces soon? So I'm glad that you are going to do that for us very quickly. So thank you so much and lots of love to
you. Thank you, Manjula. Thank you for having me here. I really enjoyed this session.
Thank you, Disha.
So much.
And of course, all of you.
All our viewers.
Hi, Meenu. so do please stay safe, stay at home, and whoever has started working, please follow all the social distancing norms.
All the guidelines.
This session is not to make you alcoholic. This session is to let you know that you have to drink responsibly. Yeah,
responsibly. Absolutely.
Thank you, everyone.
Cheers for that, Manju.
Yes, cheers. I'm very fast, so I finished.
Cheers.
Okay, you can't leave me with the glass of wine alone, I'm just done. Okay, so you enjoy. The evening is young, so enjoy now, and let's catch up soon. Bye bye, sure. Everyone. Yeah, thank you.
Thank you. Bye.
Bye. Thank you, NC. Thank you so much. Thank you, Nidhi. Say bye now. Bye.